This last month, we've been incredibly blessed with an outpouring of support and those of you that have participated, and it's just been a real blessing. And I would like to say that we made it through Pastoral Appreciation Month without anybody leaving. Normally, the devil tries to knock a family off, but I think we gained a family, Sister Angie, praise the Lord, maybe two. That's good. Amen. Yeah, the devil ain't so bad. Praise the Lord. Well, I would desire your prayers this morning. I threw Sister Liz for a loop, giving her one set of scriptures, and I placed a small fleece out before the Lord for this morning's message, and it is it's a task sometimes to know exactly what to share and when to share it, and this morning I had prepared to speak on a certain subject, but as the Sunday school progressed, it starts at 10 o'clock, by the way, Sunday school, the Lord just began to move on my heart, and I put a little fleece out there, and Sister Shelley brought some confirmation through a scripture that she shared that I would like to share too, to just use as a springboard to give you some fresh bread this morning. First, I would like for Brother Bucky, if you would, to stand and just pray that the Lord would be glorified this morning. Brother Bucky.
Father God, you're a great and a wonderful God, Lord. Yes. We know that the Word gives life, Lord God, that it can quicken our mortal bodies, Lord. But we have to be in a mindset to receive. So as your humble servant who is obedient to your voice, Lord God, and your prompting, Lord, has the freshest word available from you this morning.
Yes.
Lord God, there are hearts in here that still need to be changed and hearts that need to be broken up, Lord God, in such a way that you could encompass the entirety of their heart, Lord God, that there be nothing but the presence of your Holy Spirit, Lord God, within each one of us here today. So as this word goes forth, I pray that it would fall in fertile ground of the heart, Lord God, that we would all have ears to hear, Lord God, that it would be a blessing to each one that is here today, because you have a special word for each one that is here today. Make no mistake about it. Each one of us is here because you foreordained that today, Lord God. By our free will, we are here today to listen to the word. So please bless us as it comes forth in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I would like to say that I believe this Wednesday evening will be beneficial for you if you want to come out and understand some of the things of the Lord. I did. I counted up to 65, and I knew I missed a few, and some people pulled in the parking lot, and they said, "What's going on?" I said, "We do this every Wednesday." I'd like to invite you to come out and enjoy our Wednesday night Bible study, youth group, and also children's ministry. The Lord is blessing immensely, and I think that this week will be special, so I want to extend a special invitation. If you've been on the fence about coming to Wednesday night, we begin at 7. Praise the Lord. If you have your Bibles, I'd like for you to turn with me to Ecclesiastes, the 9th chapter, and I'm going to share a scripture very briefly that Sister Shelley shared in Sunday school, and just allow the Lord to lead and guide me. And I desire your prayers this morning that I would say exactly what needs to be said. The Bible says here in the 10th verse, "Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with all thy might. For there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave whither thou goest." I want to use this scripture as a springboard to share with you the importance of seeking the Lord now, as the scripture says, while he may be found. As I look to the Lord for my strength and my substance, you know, I'm asked all the time, how are things going at the church? People know that I'm a pastor. Every Monday morning, my boss asks me, "Did you get them all straightened out yesterday? And did you get them all squared away?" And that spawned for me a message. What does it mean to be squared away? Are you squared away? You know, because he asked me, I wanted to bring a good report. And people always ask me how things are going at the church, and I'm so happy and blessed to be able to say they are going the best that they ever had. Amen. 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 And I credit the Lord. The Lord is of course the strength of this church, and But I tell you, we have a wonderful group of people here that they've blended together more so than at any time previous. And the Lord is going to be glorified in our fellowship. As a matter of fact, the Bible talks about how that people will look at us and see how much we love one another. And that's how that we'll be known as Christ's disciple. Amen? And so we need to be disciples of the Lord. This Bible says here, whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with all thy might. I began to think about that, and I thought about what is all of our might. You know, I used to pride myself in being strong, not so much anymore. Dennis challenged me yesterday to see how many chin-ups I could do, but since my lower half has gotten bigger and my arms have gotten weaker, I don't know whether I would try it or not. But I thought about what it meant, all of your might. I thought about, you know, how that we live in a day where that churches are what's called seeker-friendly. They don't want to offend anybody. They don't want to really bring out doctrine. They don't want to really allow the Spirit to move. They don't want to offend anybody because they're afraid they'll run them off. Let me tell you something. This is a Pentecostal church. We've got the joy of the Lord. It's all right to worship the Lord. It's all right to follow the Lord in whatever manner that and you know what, a lot of people try to dictate from a position of a lack of knowledge of what goes on in the church. Listen, as a pastor, that's my job. If something goes on in church that you don't like, you don't agree with, come to me. Let's talk it out. Don't go to other people. Start talking about what's going on in the church. You know, I'm just telling you like it is. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your might. Let me get back to my message this morning because I've already offended some. They won't come back. this scripture, the latter half of it, it goes ahead and says, because there's not always going to be time to do what you've planned on doing. Amen? Amen. And I believe that we want to be seekers, and we need seekers. Amen. We need people. You're more than welcome to come to church here, but you can't dictate what goes on here. That's up to the Lord. You know, it's up to the Lord. And listen, you can't put your hands around what the Lord is doing. Just can't. You got to just say, hey, wait a minute. Listen, I want to just be obedient here and share what the Lord's laid upon my heart. I believe we need to be seekers. And I thought about what it meant to really seek with all of my might. With all of my might. You know, and that's physical strength, I guess, to a degree. Hold on. You know, and I thought about what would that be if I was, if I had my child and my child was in peril. Say we were rock climbing and my child slipped and I grabbed my child by the wrist and was hanging on to my child. How long would I hold on? You know, and that's the type of might that I want to tap into. How